doctor. He's gotta have stuff for stitches. Ow. I think it's getting worse.
House meeting in 5 minutes.
That's it.
It won't take long. There's a few things we need to discuss.
Fine.
Well, Luke has more to say, I guess. Where's Sarah?
She's got her book. She doesn't need to be a part of this.
You don't know.
She's connected to somebody.
There's no way she's out here by herself.
She said she was with a friend. They got attacked.
Yeah, right. Whoever she's with, they'll probably come looking for her.
Great. They show up and we've got her locked in the shed.
You think we should bring her in here?
No, I'm just saying it wouldn't look too good.
It's just a precautionary measure. Anyone else would do the same.
You really think Carver would come after us?
You think he wouldn't?
He's not exactly the type of...
Nothing we can do about it. Better her than I. You'd have done the same.
It wasn't the brightest idea. Oh, firing your rifle was, huh? Next time we'll just put up a neon sign that says America's welcome.
Where are you going, huh?
I want to get my sweater.
We'll be done in a minute.
I know it sounds crazy, but look, for whatever reason, I think she's telling the truth.
Look, there's no point in arguing about it now. She's in the shed. She's not going to hurt anyone. We'll just see what's what in the morning.
But Carlos said she could die if she didn't get her arm treated.
Assuming she doesn't turn.
Next room, the girl could really die.
If the infection spreads, anything's possible. You could definitely get a whole lot worse with her.
Don't we have penicillin? Or something that could, you know, stop the infection from spreading?
What if one of us needs it?
Look, I'm just saying we can help him, that's all.
We need to think of ourselves first. That's just the way it is.
We can't just let her die. Not if there's something we can do about it.
Then what happened?
We apologize for being assholes. And then we help fix her
arm. She can't stay with us. We barely have enough supplies for ourselves.
We've got more fish in the
What? Are you scared of a little girl?
A little girl is not your problem. It's who she might tell.
You gotta keep an eye on her.
If she doesn't turn, which she probably will.
I gotta take a leak. Hold on, we're almost done. If a little girl can find her way here,
then almost anyone can.
You saw those lurkers, right? It's more than we've seen in a while.
We can't just keep running. At some point, we've got to settle down.
We should, and we will. Can we find somewhere safe? I don't know.
You've seen where it lies.
If it's time to move on, then I got no problem.
Yeah, but where do we go from here?
No more cities. We all agreed on that, right?
Too many damn lurkers.
We're not going back the way we came.
We just need to look.
Wherever we go, we can't get too attached. We'll be fine, as long as we keep things fluid.
Leaving her here with me.
We can't just keep her locked in the shed. We're not animals.
Take her with you.
What?
You want to keep an eye on her? Take her with you.
Are we almost done here? I want to make sure Sarah's ready for bed. Wait a second.
clean. I'll still need some bandages and something to keep it from getting infected. Around here somewhere.
Let me in sometime.
Need to have this baby. Let it be okay. Let it be his.
You're not supposed to be in here.
I can be anywhere I want. Go away and don't tell anyone or else. Get it?
Yeah, okay. I'm sorry. I won't say anything. I'm sorry. I just thought maybe we could be friends. Please don't tell my dad I talked to you.
Help me, and I won't tell him. I'm hurt. Please help me. I shouldn't.
What happened to you?
A dog bit me.
Sounds scary. I bet it hurts.
I could die if I don't take care of it. Do you understand? I need something to clean it up, and something to wrap it with. A clean bandage.
My dad says we're out of real bandages, but I know where to get something to clean it. That's what this supplies. I'll help you.
Good.
Thank you. I'm Sarah.
I'm Clementine.
We're friends. Right? We can be best friends. I haven't met another girl my age since way before. It's hard to be the only girl, you know? Rebecca is okay, but she's old. And that's it. And if her baby is a girl, it'll be forever before she's old enough to, like, be my friend. And then I'll be super old.
We just met. We're not friends.
But we could be.
It's hard to have friends you can trust.
Which is why we should be. Come on. Please.
I'm worried about saying I'll be your friend, and then having to do something not friendly.
Come on, please.
Fine, but I warned you.
Friends. A pinky swears forever. See if I can find the stuff my dad uses when I get a gun. Let me look around. I think this is it.
That'll work.
You can't do it here, though. Someone will find you.
Don't worry, I won't. Thanks, Sarah. Not exactly bandages, but they should help stop the bleeding. This is gonna suck. Now the fun part. Now, just like last time, just how Krista showed me.
Ah! Did he get in here?
Little girl's tough as nails.
Are you all right?
The shed should have been safe.
Are you happy? I could have died, you know.
Well, you didn't.
I just needed some help.
You patched yourself up? Where'd you get that stuff?
Did she steal from us?
This doesn't change a thing. She hasn't done anything to us.
Says the man not carrying a baby.
You left me no choice.
You could have just left.
Relax, Rebecca.
Bring her in, and I'll take a look at her arm.
Damn lurker sneaking around out here. We better get inside.
You hungry?
This might hurt a little.
Ow!
How's she look?
Her suturing skills need some work, but otherwise, I say she should be fine.
So, it wasn't a lurker bite?
If it was, the fever would have already set in, and her temperature would be through the roof. I wish you wouldn't have done what you did.
What do you mean?
You manipulated my daughter.
I asked for her help.
She's not someone you can just ask for help. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt, but there are a few things you need to know about my daughter.
Okay.
She isn't like you. You may not get that initially, but once you're around her for a while, you'll understand. If she knew how bad the world is, what it's really like out there, she would cease to function. She's my little girl. She's all I have left, and I would ask that you stay away from her.
She needs to grow up sometime.
You do not know what she needs! Rebecca was worried you might be working with someone else, that your being here was no accident. I guess we'll find out. But one thing I know for sure, you are not to be trusted. Stay away from my daughter.
Hey, brought you some food if you're hungry. That's gonna leave one hell of a scar. Yeah. You know, I get it. You're pissed that we locked you up, and I'm sorry.
Hey, look. I just want to say I'm sorry for... well, for being a dick out there. I got kind of aggro, and that was definitely not cool.
Nick's been known to go off every once in a while. Don't hold it against him.
Yeah, I guess we all have our moments.
You definitely had one out there.
You were just protecting your friends. I get it.
Well, I didn't mean to be so harsh. I just... we had a bad experience once.
What happened?
Nick lost his mom. We took care of someone who got bit.
It was my fault.
It was no one's fault. We thought we could control it, but we couldn't. And then she turned, and his mom was standing right there, and she got attacked. And there was nothing we could do about it.
Anyway, hopefully you understand.
I do. Yeah.
So, since you're pretty much on your own, what's your plan?
I'm thinking about moving on.
Well, you're welcome to stay here if you want. You can let yourself heal up, take some time to sort things out.
Do you think everyone else will be okay with it?
They'll just have to deal with it. So, what happened to your parents? If you don't mind me asking. I mean, I assume what happened to them is what happened to just about everyone's parents. You're just so young. Didn't think you could have made it on your own for so long, but maybe you did.
They died.
That's tough. I lost my folks too. Hey, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have asked.
My parents went on vacation and left me with a babysitter, and they never came back. We went to Savannah to find them, but they were already dead.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
This man found me and took care of me. We met up with other survivors, and we all tried to make it. But it didn't work. His name was Lee. He taught me how to survive. He's the reason I keep my hair short.
What happened to him?
I killed him. He got bitten, protecting me. And I had to kill him before he turned.
Wow.
I had to.
I hate to interrupt, but I'm out there standing watch and I can't help but notice this place is lit up like a goddamn beacon in the middle of the woods.
Yeah, it's time to turn in anyways.
Now get your winks while you can, because we're going fishing at first light. Couple fresh brookies for dinner? Wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, you're still here. I wouldn't be comfortable if I were you.
Whose baby is it?
Excuse me?
If it's not Alvin's, whose is it?
You shut your fucking mouth.
You should probably think about being nicer to me. That's just my advice.
I knew you were going to be a fucking problem. You got what you came here for. Now go.
How you holding up? I heard you got an earful from Rebecca last night. Once she gets going, there's no bringing her back. Her bark's worse than her bite.
She's all talk. She doesn't scare me.
She was in a mood last night, that's for sure.
How far are these fish traps?
It ain't much further. Anyone teach you how to shoot? By that I mean taught proper. Any idiot with a finger can shoot.
My friend Lee taught me.
That's good. It's important nowadays. Nick was about your age, first time I took him hunting. Came across this beautiful 13-point buck just standing there on the ridgeline.